Previously on Apocalypse World, you finally reached Reagan's Hope and dropped off the crates with Carter. Last decided to snoop and discovered that one of the crates was full of discarded cyber limbs. He and Farley later worked together to fix the carnival while Crossfade did some laundry and Rita set up an infirmary in the truck in a response to, a staff emergency. When the crew opens up the carnival for the night, Crossfade gives a mesmerizing performance that drives the patrons into a frenzy. It ends, you close, and all seems well. Until Farley wakes up in the middle of the night from an unsettling dream. Excellent. I've found you. Farley, you're startled awake in a panic after hearing this voice in your dream. You shoot upright in the driver's seat in a cold sweat. You could have sworn there was someone in here with you. What do you do?
So I'm in the driver's seat, but where am I? What time is it? Like, what do I see? I'm just trying to, like, get my bearings right now. I'm like, I'm just figuring out if I'm in reality or not.
So Reagan's Hope is lit artificially by, a network of lamps that produce almost like an artificial sunlight effect. It brightens and dims with the sunlight outside, actually, according to what time it is. The lights are just starting to turn up right now. You think it's morning.
So how real did this feel?
It felt extremely real.
So I started like grasping around trying to make sure like I feel things as well. And when I do, Farley turns around and I think maybe this isn't really stuff that he's experienced a lot of, so I think he's probably just gonna, like, you know, run his hands down his face and, like, stretch it out and, like, and just kind of, like, smack himself awake. And he'll hop over to the back and just find the first sleeping person, i.e. hopefully gets to Crossfade first.
Well, Crossfade is asleep in the blanket nest under their booth, which I assume is kind of towards the back of the, you know, the trailer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But I don't know where everybody else is sleeping. I assume Lash just sleeps wherever he falls.
He's got a hammock that he sets up here and there.
Yeah. The person who was it that saw the face, the fox mask, right? And I was like, I saw that person in my dream. That was you. Yeah, exactly. So yeah. Yes. So this is why Farley is going to Crossfade. So Farley is like waking. Shh. Hey.
What the fuck? Good morning.
Did you have any mask people dreams? Well, like, I just had one and I'm fucking freaking out.
Crossfade's like half asleep. Like what, like tonight?
Yeah. Or
just like recently?
Just now. I would have spoken up if it was recently, maybe.
Okay. Well, I don't think so.
Okay.
I mean, not last night. Tonight, I don't know, what time is it?
It's like 6:00. It's morning.
Ugh.
It's
dawn. Fucking disgusting. Nah, weirdly enough, I didn't have any crazy dreams last night.
Huh. You think maybe I swallowed them up from you somehow? At least, like, transferred?
Well, like, it's not contagious. I don't think.
I don't know, that party was pretty crazy.
Yeah, dude. That got wild. That's fucking awesome. You didn't eat any of those funky mushrooms, did you?
No, you think I should?
Not if you don't want your brain to go psychic soup time. But, I mean, if you do want that, then yeah,
that doesn't sound great, no.
I mean, depends on the day, right?
So yeah,
but nah, I didn't have any weird dreams last night. You okay? What happened?
Yeah, you know what? Maybe it was just really vivid. You know, I don't have a lot of vivid dreams. I don't usually have dreams. There's also that.
So like, did you hit the spice too hard last night?
I didn't hit any spice.
Well, okay. Well, now I'm confused. I don't know. That's weird.
Well, sorry for waking you. Maybe let me make it up for you. I can make some breakfast. I'll make breakfast for all of us. Let me make it up to you. What do you want?
Breakfast would be good.
What can I do for you?
I don't know, man. You slap it on a plate, I'll eat it.
You're going to regret that. Farley goes into the kitchen.
Farley, how good of a cook are you?
Oh, no.
I don't know. I don't think Farley is a driver. What does he know of cooking? That's Rita's. That's Rita's. And 16 and 17, you know, like, that's all that's their thing. I don't.
I mean, I assume that it is not Farley's job. Yeah. Farley, you feel like someone is watching you.
So I'm just like, I'm sautéing some meat right now. So like I like pour meat from our like tub of
like a meat tub.
Yeah, we have like a meat tub, right? Like unscrew the top and no. I'm just like pour.
Sauteed meat from the tub.
Fresh from the tub, baby. Mm-hmm. That's how we like it.
And as it's like sizzling, I start feeling like this hissing behind me or something. And like I feel like maybe it's like I don't know what it is. And I like look behind me and like I maybe get my hand too close to the stove and I'm like, ah, fuck, when I look behind me, because I turned around so quickly and I'm like startled. I don't see anything, do I? Or do I?
You don't see anything.
Okay. Yeah. Farley's just on edge and he's looking around for just literally anything. He like goes to the windows. He looks out the door, tries to see if there's somebody that could be peering into the carnival. Probably doesn't see anybody.
You see a couple people setting up shops at the market.
Yeah, but nothing suspicious.
They're close enough to the carnival mm-hmm. to have been, you know, looking into the windows. Mm-hmm. At least not as of a minute ago when you felt like there was someone watching you.
I think Crossfade is concerned by this and eventually extricates themselves from the blanket nest and makes their way towards the kitchen to try to check on Farley, and maybe he turns around and sees them in the doorway.
Yeah. I think like between various like startled noises and the smell of cooking meat, it's probably like kind of cue for other people to wake up as well.
Rex is gonna roll out of his hammock and don his cod piece and then silicone jacket.
Put on his uniform.
actually his cod piece, then shoulder holster, then silicone jacket.
Ah. Every time you remind me that last basically only wears a codpiece, it hits me like a fucking train.
Hey, I have a special ability where I get two armor if I'm naked or nearly naked.
Yes, I'm aware.
You make this very clear at all times.
He's just got his cyberpunk Conan look going at all times.
Yeah, also, yeah, I figured the silicone jacket is handy for, like, all the liquids just go right off of it, and it doesn't obstruct the view for anybody.
It's very thoughtful.
Becomes like walking and just yawning. Oh, what's all the noise? It's so early.
My Crossfade walks in and scares the shit out of Farley by accident.
Yeah.
hey buddy. No. Hey, are you you know, I'm gonna sit with you, just, you know, I'll keep an eye out, how about that?
For what?
I don't know, you're just acting kind of jumpy. Makes me feel better if I'm feeling jumpy, if somebody is just kind of sitting there.
Last is gonna go wander off and find Rita and wake her up.
Yeah, Crossway just hops up on the counter and is like just sitting up there, just perched like a little gargoyle on the counter.
I'm assuming Rita has her own cabin.
Nah, man, Rita, she's among the workers. She's sitting up.
Okay, well, then I jostle.
Rita is a woman of the people.
Last jostles Rita's shoulder. Hey, wake up, wake up.
Yeah, what's up?
I don't know, something's going on. I heard screaming and banging in the kitchen. I think something's wrong with our driver.
Screaming and banging in the kitchen?
Right, like, and not the good kind.
I grab my shotgun.
And aim it at my own face. No.
Rita, you put your hand on the wall where the shotgun track is, and you hear it rattling along the track, and then it suddenly stops, like, right next to your hand. You take it off the wall.
So convenient.
It's so convenient. It's literally my favorite thing. It's the favorite thing I've got on this.
Anyway, something's happening. I thought you might want to be up.
Thanks for that. I'm ahead to the kitchen.
It's early. I hope they made coffee.
There's just meat. There's just meat patties just right now.
Tough meat.
Good. Sizzling, yeah. Farley, you'll see Farley like over the frying pan, just like making patties with the spatula and just kind of like slapping them onto like some plates, onto some burgers maybe, some burger patties. I think, yeah. Oh, okay. And nice. He just looks
breakfast
like
burgers. Yeah, baby.
Yeah, and he just looks kind of like strung out right now. Like he's just. He's like on top of the fact that he's like probably hungover, like and tired from the awesome party last night. There's something else where he doesn't look like he's. He obviously looks like more troubled or something, like something's not right. And Crossfade's also like sitting right next to him.
Yeah, I'm perched, crouched on the counter,
which is also like an unusual sight, I am sure.
What time is it?
Morning?
It's roughly 6:30 a.m.
It's like 6. 7.
It's really good for an overnight caravan.
It's not my favorite hour.
Yeah, it's a weird time for burgers. And all this noise. I was brought to a panic. I heard there was like screams and noises.
Yeah, no, I burned my hand is all. And yeah.
I don't know what's up with this kitchen, but everyone keeps injuring their hands in here. I'm gonna have to make a safety video.
Yeah, I think my union's gonna have something to say about that.
In the background, in the background, Last reaches over and crosses off the one and puts a zero on the Deus Ex. But he had just changed before. Like, he was just in the process of changing back to the one as you guys were talking.
Employee training video.
Yeah, I gotta make a safety video now. Like, we get one person, their hand gets cut open, and now we gotta hand fire. I gotta get a robot. We gotta get a robot.
No, we don't. We don't need a robot. We don't need a robot. Robots are garbage.
I mean,
they all turn into homicidal fucks.
I mean,
I guess just the ones that can talk.
Depending who you ask.
What about like a Roomba? Like a space Roomba.
I do like that.
A Sproomba.
I wanted to say it so badly, but I didn't want to hear it.
Well, I got you.
Thanks.
Oh, space.
Yeah.
We should get a Roomba. We could tape knives to it.
What if
oh, great.
Knife
yeah.
On?
nothing like homicidal Roomba spinning around like crazy with fucking knives slashing your shins.
Yeah,
no.
It's like a game. If it gets your ankle, you're out.
Yeah, it'll creep, and it also serves as home protection.
Last man standing is the winner.
It's basically a quiet chihuahua, and I don't see the problem here.
That's true.
That's what they said about all the little bots with knives.
I mean, yes, there was a one, but I mean, we don't really know how bad the I wasn't alive for the robot apocalypse. I mean, like, yeah, they say it was bad, or how much of that's just, you know, propaganda to get people to utilize slave labor more. I don't know. You know, maybe robots are fine now. I want to shut up.
You hear from the doorway, are you guys going to replace us with robots?
No, I'm not going to replace you with robots.
16 and 17 are standing there.
Yeah, see, my,
16 look very tired.
They do their parents fighting.
My union will not stand for the automation of our jobs.
All right, now I need a robot driver.
Class turns around and looks at them and says, well, you're not going to live forever.
Robots last. No one's getting replaced by robots.
I don't really like the sound of that.
Especially not with knife Roomba roaming around.
That just shrugs at that comment.
Wait, we're gonna get a knife Roomba?
No.
Maybe. No, we're not gonna get a knife Roomba.
That's for sure.
So, very, very briefly.
See, look what all this conversation about robots. Robot. Look what all this conversation of robots has done.
Everyone's in a panic.
Give me 16, some of that meat.
17, you're not going to be replaced by robots. You'll be able to have proper names, and you'll have free time, like more free time. You'll be able to lounge during business hours.
You have to have a robot for them to have names. That would
be really nice, actually.
Yeah. Automation does not mean the end of enjoyment. You're not going to be replaced by a robot. Well, I mean, you will be, but you're not going to lose your place on the ride. Oh.
That would be nice. That would be really nice because, you know, I can't really go home to the settlement that I'm from.
Yeah.
Not after that big.
Why not?
You know, you almost lost a hand. A robot, you know, it wouldn't lose its hand. If it did, it could just buy another hand.
Yeah, that's true, I guess.
Crosshead holds up their prosthetic and they're like,
how are you feeling?
And we can do that too.
I had to, you know, that booze was kind of strong. You all right?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm just, you know, I have a headache and stuff.
Yeah,
eat some tub meat. It'll make you feel better.
Oh, I love tub meat. It's my favorite.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Farley's making burgers at 6 in the morning.
Yeah.
Wait, Farley can cook?
Yeah.
The plates are placed in front of you, and they are sloppy and greasy and runny meat with, like, on an open face bun because we're low on burger buns.
It's hot, God.
16 looks at it, and they look up at you, Farley, and they go, "It kind of looks a little burnt
somehow."
You want some salt?
When I say Farley can cook, I meant it in the literal verbal sense, not the artisanal sense.
Right, like he is able to.
He's capable of performing the action known as cooking.
He has the power.
He does not cook like he drives.
We can all only be good at one thing, okay?
One task, that's it.
Speak for yourself.
Master of not master of one.
So
16 is like, but wait, I can cook and I can bartend.
But can you do both as well as I drive?
Not at the same time. No.
That's why. Because you're dividing your attention. You're not specializing.
Well, yeah, but like I can't be in the kitchen and at the bar at the exact same time. Like that's not possible.
That's why you don't do them at the same time. You pick one and you focus on it. And you focus on it so much that all you do is define yourself by that job.
That kind of sounds like Reaganite propaganda. A little bit.
Yeah, just be yourself.
Oh, Jesus, what have I become?
Because you're probably going to die soon. Horribly.
Farley, screaming. Just hangs his head over his meat bun. He's like, oh, God.
I don't think that really helps very much.
I'm sorry, guys. I just...
That's just shrugs.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, no.
CrossFit's patting your shoulders.
No. I'm fine. Hey, look, not crying. All is well. Eat your meat.
I wanted to ask, are we sticking around for a while, or are we going to get going?
We should probably get going.
Yeah, I thought we were gonna jet today, right?
Yeah, I wanted to jet, 8 hours ago.
I mean, people are setting up market stuff out there already. Do we want to do any trading before we go?
Does anyone actually need anything right now? I'm pretty good.
We are low on burger buns.
That's true.
Fine, let's get some burger buns.
Yeah, we need to find a yeast shop. Let's get some yeast.
Yeah, it's good to have.
Or wheat. How do you make bread? It's yeast, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's
powder,
flour.
Flour.
Flour, that's right. That's what that powder's called. Yeah.
Clean, warm water, preferably.
Yeah, salt. Anybody got any fucking cyberware oil? My fucking elbow's starting to get stiff.
CrossFit, the market is pretty sizable. You think that you can probably find... You kind of get the sense that you can find basically whatever you need.
Cool. I was more asking if anyone here has any or if I have to go buy some.
All right.
I mean, there's some bacon fat over there.
Oh, that's true.
I think it's bacon.
Oh, but you can't get the smell out, though.
I mean, why would you want to?
The last time I tried that, I had fucking flies the size of my eyeballs on me for a week.
Free food.
We have a little bit of canola oil. Is that gonna work? Or is it motor oil?
CrossFit just stares at them.
Yeah. So I'm wondering.
I'm sorry. I don't have any cyberware. I wouldn't know.
Exactly. Don't ask stupid questions.
So I'm wondering. it sounds to me like maybe we need more quality ingredients.
What do you think, 16?
Yeah, I mean, we are running... I mean, you know, we are running low on, burger buns and stuff. I think we're out of some of the herbs that we use. We could really use more soy sauce.
Yeah, could use more soy sauce. All right, You know what? Let's just do a shopping trip.
Or we are underneath Reagan's Hope, where all the rich people live with even fancier ingredients.
So you want to pull a heist?
I mean, we're already here, right?
That's a terrible idea.
It's a terrible idea. I'm mad that I like it as much as I do. All right.
We could double the profits.
All right, okay.
I mean, you could go to the market, you can get some subpar stuff, you could get your yeast and your powder flour and whatever, but in the end of the day, isn't the special sauce the sauce?
I mean, it's the spice.
Spice. There's other spices as well, apparently, that you can sprinkle on stuff that's not salt. Yeah.
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 But the spice really carries things. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, y'all are gonna get us all killed. Okay. So, let's say, hypothetically speaking, we go and raid the upper crust of Reagan's Hope. We need a good out would be ideal. We would need, honestly, that's about it. We could just guess with the target. I mean, it's not going to be that hard. But it's going to be loud. It's going to be probably messy.
And so you're thinking a smash and grab?
Too unattended.
Alright. I just want to say, I hate this. I hate this idea. I hate this place.
I do too.
Here's the thing, though. There's a reason why everybody you see walking around down here looks like they're about to drop dead any minute. And it's because nothing you can buy down here has got any nutritional value in it whatsoever.
True.
Which also means no flavor.
Okay. All right. You're from...
Unless you like eating, having all your food have the taste and the texture of a rice cracker. That's... Fair. You're not going to get it around here.
All right. So, Crossfade, you're from here, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right. So, basically, we need some loose version of a plan.
Yeah.
So that way we have at least a means of getting in and out of this, because we're going to need to do that pretty soon. Like, once things are up... Like, I mean, as much as I love a smash and grab, if we can do this quietly, that'd be even better, because you can get more for less effort.
Yeah, I would suggest that one. And not the one where there's a lot of guys with guns in suits coming after us, because that's what will happen the other way around.
Yeah, I think that's going to be pretty much guaranteed. Just by being here for too long, which I'm not excited about, and causing more trouble isn't exactly exciting, but fuck it, we're here, and I'm troublesome.
Yeah, plus you hate it so much here. Rob 'em blind.
Ah! We did that. You not remember? We did that already, Farley. That's why we try not to come back here.
Or we just do it again. They won't expect it the second time.
Any time you get to give the Bubble Boys the middle finger, I'm good with that.
All right. You know what? Let's do the highest.
Yes! And Farley's just excited to, like, get his mind on something else entirely.
He's just like, fuck yeah, heist.
Heist. But he still feels something watching him.
Alright, well, if we're gonna do a heist, there's one thing that I want that we haven't been able to have here. Coffee. I desperately want coffee. Like, real coffee. Yeah.
Real coffee?
I never had anything that didn't heat up in a microwave in a minute.
Yeah. Yeah, no, the real deal. Coffee, like, heat, pressure, hot water, ground, real coffee. That's what we're gonna, if we're gonna do this, I mean, like, if we're gonna go all in like this,
might as well make it worth it.
Exactly. Like,
all right, so we want to raid some coffee.
Yes.
All right. You want to make that the focus? You just add coffee to the menu and then, you know, maybe pick up some other stuff along the way, but.
Yep. Maybe. What's the word on reaching out to, Carter? I'm sure she's got some insights on the upper crust, and we might be able to find a good spot to hit.
Yeah, she seemed like a person that knows shit about things, but I don't know if I trust like that.
That's valid.
Carter definitely does seem well connected to you.
Yeah.
You figure that if anybody who you know here would know where to procure items in Reagan's Hope, it would be her.
Yeah, we don't have to tell her the major details. I mean, we've got enough coin to legitimately do commerce in the upper end.
Commerce.
But you could make a lot more of a profit if you didn't buy the goods you planned to sell.
Not to mention, we're not supporting this economy. We're not supporting this rigged economy.
We have the money to at least look like we have business up there, which is the important thing. Like, we could reasonably ask about, hey, where do I get this expensive item, and not immediately be really suspicious about it.
Well, hey, it's Reagan's Hope, right? So let's do some fucking trickle down.
Why you want to Robin Hood this shit?
All right, so what do you plan on doing?
All right, I guess I'm going to reach out to Carter.
Mm-hmm.
Farley will hand over the car phone.
Yeah. And I'm going to call up Carter.
All right.
On the car phone.
Okay. Hello? Carter picks up. It kind of sounds like she is still half asleep.
Hey, Carter.
Hey.
I'm in the search for some damn good coffee. Money is no object here. I am willing to spend as much as necessary to get quality coffee. I just need to know where to go for it.
If you're looking for coffee, I think that, you know, I mean, if you want the raw stuff, there's probably a warehouse that you can get it in down here, but if you don't have the means to prepare it on your own, you'll probably want to look at the artisan district up top.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There are probably roasters and shops up there that you might be able to look into.
Okay. I think that's the same equipment that I would need for the soy stuff, yeah? Grinder? Filter?
Sorry, what?
It's probably the same stuff, right? Grinder, water, filter?
Yeah, same equipment, generally. Yeah, you could probably get some, espresso machines up there, too.
That sounds like a great idea. Thanks. Sorry for waking you up and calling so early.
It's all right. I probably should have been up 10 minutes ago anyway. Anyway, if you need to know anything else, let me know. I can drop you a pin to my shop. If you want to talk in person or anything.
What's the deal with this artisanal district? Like, how high is it?
Yeah. No, I think I'm good there. I just gotta head out there. Thank you, though.
Welcome. All right. Oh, good luck up there.
All right. Good luck. And, yeah.
All right.
Well, here's the thing about this shithole of a place. They don't like it when us little bottom people come up onto their nice crust city and get our, you know, tunnel dust in it. So, if you want to get past the guards to get upside, we're gonna have to look like we have a fucking reason to be there. You know?
Yeah, this is gonna cost, probably some. Which, it's fine. We've got some decent amount of barter left to flow, you know. Because I don't think they're going to take tabs here. I wish they fucking would. You've got enough, we can probably get in the door. I wager. And we might have to buy our way through, but whatever. We're getting a pretty good deal on the goods that we're looking for, so I think it's a fair trade.
Mm-hmm.
I'll put on my nice clothes.
Yeah. Gotta love a 5-finger discount.
Mm-hmm.
Indeed.
All right, so do all of you have nice clothes, or is it just Rita who happens to have a nice set of clothes?
I think it's just Rita. Definitely not me.
I have a slightly nicer jacket I can put on.
This transparent silicone jacket of mine is incredibly nice.
It's true.
Fucking Burberry.
Crossfade, you feel like the slightly nicer jacket that you have is probably not going to be enough for the upper crust of Reagan's Hope. Farley, you know you are not going to get in anywhere fancy, even remotely.
Yeah. My shirt literally has a bunch of duct tape all over it to patch the holes, so yeah.
We've all got one outfit each.
Yeah. Yeah.
It probably smells a little bit, too.
Oh, yeah.
No, the laundry thing last session.
Yeah, it's true. My clothes are clean and smell great.
Yeah, laundry happened.
Did you do anybody else's laundry for them?
Hell no.
No.
Nobody has any more clothes.
Farley spent the session fixing the carnival and then partying. So yeah, yeah, no, he's got a musk.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah. I mean, it's probably not that hard underground in Reagan's Hope. It's a little bit hotter on the surface.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because I tend to get more. It tends to get, well, not in Reagan's Hope. Reagan's Hope is climate controlled.
So stay up in the bubble, it would be. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it stays between a nice, 70 to 78 degrees.
Man.
Depending on, season, time of day, stuff like that.
The one rich person saying, turn it down, turn it up.
Yeah.
Turn it down.
Stop touching the thermostat.
You're going to cost us a fortune in tax tabs.
All right.
So yeah, you to get the sense that you will probably need to buy additional clothing if you want to fit in. Last, you don't give a shit. You're just gonna wear your transparent trench coat and your codpiece.
Last is gonna get in whether they like it or not.
Those are pretty nice boots too.
And your boots. Can't forget the boots.
All right.
Listen, Last
isn't here to be fashionable. He is here to he is here to be fashionable, and he is here to make a statement that is all his own.
I was about to say, what are you talking about? Last is the most fashionable person among them.
Yeah, totally.
He's not concerned with anybody else's idea of what fashion is. Is what I mean.
Fashion fades, style is forever.
All right. So you figure that you can possibly, maybe, find something down here if you know where to look.
All right. Let's do some. What do you guys want to do? Market hopping.
I know a guy.
We'll just hide you in the back of the truck.
Yeah, that's fine.
See if you can get me like a trench coat or something.
You want still see through or like?
No, okay. Not for this purpose.
Alright. That you can do, that's easy.
The Reaganites don't deserve a look at this.
Holds gigantic pec titty.
they couldn't handle it.
No, they could not.
All right. So, sounds to me like we're doing a market shopping roll or move. So, who's got good sharp? Actually, I guess you would.
My sharp's okay. That's pretty good. It's plus two.
Rather, who has sharp highlighted?
I do.
That's probably the better question.
Yeah.
It's me.
And I feel
and
like,
I have plus two sharp, so.
Yeah, and this is your town,
this
you know.
This is my territory.
Like, yeah, I think you should definitely get a roll.
That I hate and don't want to be in. Nobody fucks with my town, except for me. Okay.
Well, Crossfade, I will give you plus two on this roll because you are from Reagan's Hope.
All right. So I'm going to roll to find a shady back alley clothing smuggler that I know of. To get us some nice topside clothing that I'm sure he has. You just got to find him. That's the only thing. Okay.
Oh boy.
Go. Roll.
Whoa.
What did I roll? Holy
nice. All right. That is a 15. I don't think it's possible to roll any higher than that.
Ever. You know that primo shit.
I could have rolled a 16. Yeah. I had a plus four on that roll, so I'll have you
okay. So you don't. It's been a while since you've been in Reagan's Hope. You're not 100% sure if your information is current, but you do know the location of a, good quality, clothing smuggler, essentially. They do sell topside quality clothes here. Most of it is actually secondhand, but, you know, rich people, they will discard their clothing as soon as it goes out of fashion. So pretty much none of it is heavily worn.
He just goes dumpster diving up top. He sneaks up there and he goes dumpster diving for people's thrown out clothes. Mm-hmm. And then comes down and sells it.
That is exactly what he does. You have the authority to establish it that.
This is my
15 on your dice.
This is my city now.
So yeah, it says for the move, yes, you can just go buy it like that. So
we call him Joey Cravat. Because he's so fancy.
Joey Cravat.
Excellent. Excellent. All right. You know where Joey Cravat's store is located.
It's establishment.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a lean-to in an alley. Okay. Am I doing this shopping alone, or is anybody with me?
Oh, I'm coming. I'm coming.
I'm coming with you as well. I'm gonna leave the thing for once.
I'll hang back and keep an eye on the vehicle.
Sounds good.
Unless you think you'll need my help.
Nah, probably not. We're good. Okay. So we're rolling up on this. So he'll lead you through a bunch of like weird, twisty back alleys. To eventually find this man in his shady establishment, which it could barely be called a building. Awesome. It's more like, it's like a shack. And it looks like, I think when we get in, that this is not a permanent establishment. This is just where he happens to be today.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So.
I can expect a mobile businessman.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I would hope so.
That right. Joey. He's so wacky.
Okay, so what is Joey Cravat like?
I think he's like, he's always wearing like a cravat, which is why they call him Joey.
Of course.
So he's always wearing like really like fancy clothes, but he does look like he's just come out of a dumpster at all times.
Okay. All right. Excellent. I love it.
Skinny, scraggly beard, and he's just always got dirt on his face, but he's wearing just really nice clothes.
All right. Yeah, so Joey Cravat's establishment is open. He is there. Hello, welcome. Welcome to Joey Cravat's. How can I help you today? And he has this fucking voice, apparently.
Yeah. He sounds like He is dangerously close to becoming Berries and Cream, just so you know. So be careful.
I'm not gonna lie, Berries and Cream Lad was on my mind.
I knew it. Anyway.
Yes.
Hey, Joey. Me and my associates here need to get hooked up with some, you know, more respectable digs, if you know what I mean.
Yes, I know exactly what you mean. Respectable digs is my specialty here at my store, Joey Cravats. I do have a plethora of clothing items to choose from. You may browse as you like.
Ooh,
I have a fitting room where you can try any of this on. He motions to a little curtained off area in the back.
I like to turn to the other two and I'm like, I fucking love this place. It makes me feel like a goddamn Rockefeller.
Yeah, like this is fancy for my tastes.
Ass is looking for the long coats.
Yeah, like, hey Joey, do you have a big and tall section?
yes, I believe so. There are a few big and tall outfits that I have there in that corner over there. He points to the corner opposite of the fitting room.
It's like a shower curtain.
There are a number of outfits over there. A lot of them are like long coats and absurdly long dresses that look like they were made for people who are like 7 feet tall.
Yeah, Lass just goes over there and shucks off his silicone jacket and starts trying on some different long coats.
Oh, can you please try this on in the fitting room? This is a refined establishment. We do have rules here. And I would appreciate it very much if you followed them.
Last, wearing a trench coat and takes the dress with him to the fitting room.
Excellent.
Farley's eyes are immediately drawn to a poncho, and he's like, ooh. And it's like this, it's just this really fancy knit poncho, and he just puts it on over his outfit and he twirls. He's like, this is so stupid, I love it.
That poncho is excellent for twirling. It is very warm. And it is a little bit scratchy.
Yeah.
But it looks incredible. What's the color scheme of this poncho?
I want to say like red with like yellow zigzags through it.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Love it.
Yeah. He's just like, oh, this is the one. It's also minimal effort. See, look, it's literally one hole. Woof. Poncho on, poncho off. Poncho on, poncho off.
He looked like a hot dog. I love it.
Yeah, this is the one.
All right.
Ring me up. I'm spending the barter right now.
Oh, this is one of my favorite pieces. I love it so much. I am so happy that you appreciate it as much as I do. That's going to be one barter.
One barter.
Please.
Done. Slide over all the tabs that that one barter becomes for this poncho.
All right.
Oops, okay, sorry, everybody almost died.
Yeah. Are you all right? But,
yeah, I'm good. I just choked on my water.
Oh no.
Sorry.
I'm fine.
Les spends a long time in the fitting room, and there's some shuffling noises, and eventually comes out looking just like he did when he went in, wearing the long coat and carrying the dress. He puts it back up and picks up his silicone jacket and takes off the long coat and puts on his silicone jacket.
No! The please change in the changing room only. I insist upon it. I do have it there for a reason.
Relax, man. It's already done. And I gesture down towards my codpiece and say, and Willy Wonka's in the chocolate factory.
I don't like this euphemism.
It's bad, yeah.
If you're going to buy something, then please just make a purchase.
Yeah, this. I hold up the jacket that I turned on.
Okay. That's going to be 2 barter. Please.
2?
2, yes. Dang. 1 barter for the coat and 1 barter for the inconvenience.
Sort of lean over and say, it's really no inconvenience to have me around shopping here.
It really is, though. It really is. You refuse to follow my rules in my refined establishment. And I would really just appreciate it so much if you would follow my rules.
Halfway through that sentence, he's looking down the barrel of my automatic.
Okay, yes. Don't shoot me or anything. I suppose I can reduce it to 1 barter. If
I put the tabs on the table, grab my jacket, holster the pistol.
All right, thank you for your business, young man.
Flip him off.
Well, that's just not necessary. That's just very rude. I would really appreciate it if you were not rude to me in my refined establishment.
Yeah, Farley, be refined, twirls and poncho.
Yes, see, this man gets it.
I'll give you some tips, man. About.
Oh, thank you so much. You are so kind. You and your tabs are welcome here anytime. Crossfade, what are you getting?
Oh gosh.
Does anything catch your eye?
They have any very like fabulous crop top jackets?
They do. They have
what I'm always looking for.
Yes, they have one extremely fabulous crop top jacket. It's
fancy ass crop top jacket with a high collar.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm going for. I'm making a beeline.
It is, okay, so if you've seen, like, the, layer of, like, iridescent color that, occurs, like, on the top of an oil spill, that is what this jacket looks like.
Oh my god, I need it.
Mm-hmm. All right, that's
my fucking look.
Yeah. All right. Okay, so you bring it up to the counter, and, Joey Cravat, adjusts his cravat, very uncomfortably. He is clearly very upset by the way that last has treated him.
Hey, so, about Big and Tall over there, hey, don't take it personally, he's really nervous. He's never been to a fancy party before.
Oh, is that so?
Yes, this is his first time dressing up.
Oh, well, if I had known that, then, I would have extended a little bit of grace to him. Because it is a very, very nerve-wracking going to your very first fancy party.
I know. I'm just, like, nodding.
It's a very stressful experience, and especially if you don't know what to wear to the party.
See, you and I, we done this dance.
Yes.
1,000 times, but he's never done it before, so.
Oh, absolutely.
Sorry about that. I'll talk to him when we get home. How about?
Okay. Yes, that would be nice. I would also really enjoy having an apology from him because he did shove a gun in my face just a moment ago, and it was very uncomfortable for me. I don't really enjoy being threatened by customers. It does not make me feel good. It makes me feel very bad, in fact.
That is actually how he expresses approval. He fucking loves your establishment.
Oh, well, that's very interesting.
He's interesting. When you get to know him, you start to read all his little ticks.
He must come from a very unusual culture.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, Steph, what was that?
He comes from the barons, you see.
Yeah, he's a wastelander, so.
Oh, he's one of those little barons rats. Yes, I understand.
We're just grateful he doesn't need a muzzle, okay?
It's different.
So you all have trained him very well.
Yup.
Sometimes I think he's trained us.
Oh, God.
Oh, well, isn't that sweet? yes, all right. So, anyhow, if you would like this jacket, it's going to be one butter.
All right. There you are, my good man. Joey, keep it fabulous.
Thank you. Thank you very
catch
much.
Catch you on the flip side, my man.
I don't believe that I've ever seen you before, but I feel like I know you from somewhere.
You know, I get that a lot. Bye. And then I walk out.
All right, bye. Also, sorry, Rita, I can't remember. Were you with a group or not?
I was.
Okay. All right, is there anything that you would like to purchase?
Nope, I just came here to make sure nobody died. Mission accomplished.
We made it.
All right.
No casualties of this shopping trip.
As surprising. Well. Leaving as a group, like, last sort of turns toward the last and flips the guy off again. Does, like, the double-fisted flip off, which I can't do because I have push to talk on, but...
I'm like, kind of, shove last out. I'm like, easy, come on, just
let's go. Some of that is not necessary!
CrossFit is like, oh, he's waving goodbye. That's so nice. Come on, guys.
CrossFit, I would like you to mark an experience for that. good justification of last's horrible rudeness.
Listen, Joey Cravat kind of deserves it, so it's fine. But I don't want to burn any bridges in case I need another nice jacket later. That's all. You know how it is.
Your friends seem nice. I say as we walk down the sidewalk a little ways.
Yeah.
I mean, you tried to fuck me, but, you know. Well, I guess you expect that on a first impression sometimes.
Yeah. I mean, you just got a real powerful aura to you, lass. What can I say?
Yeah, can't help it. Can't be helped.
Rules. My ass.
I know.
Yeah, all right. So, all right, well, that's one step done.
We're fancy lads now, crew.
It's not even 8 o'clock yet, and you've already had an adventure.
What is the next stage in your plan, crew?
Ride the guards to get to the crest, no?
No, next we gotta get up top. Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
Gotta take the long lift up top.
So I assume that you're all changing into your fancy outfits.
Oh, yes.
Poncho on.
Yeah, Les is gonna leave the transparent long coat behind and don the opaque one.
Yeah, I'm putting the jacket on, but it's just over everything I was already wearing. Except for, like, the cape, which I take off.
Oh, you take the cape.
I do take my cape off because it, you know, the high collar and the cape, it's a little much.
Oh, okay. Not gonna go full space Dracula.
No. Not today. Maybe next time.
So Crossfade,
yes.
You didn't actually catch this when you looked at the when you were purchasing the jacket.
Okay.
But you get back to the carnival and, you know, you put it on. And in the process of, you know, taking it off of its hanger and, you know, putting it onto yourself, you notice that on the back of the jacket is a logo for a band called the Black Lungs.
Ah. God damn it.
Problem.
Fucking hell. No, these guys fucking suck. That's all.
You know what they say.
You know, it's fine. I'm putting on a new persona for the night, right? So everybody can think I have bad taste. It's fine.
Yeah, it'll be great. It'll be great.
It'll be great. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so we're dressed for the occasion. We've got a go plan. We're going, oh yeah. Do you want to hit warehouses? Likely to be a little bit lighter. I mean, get some nice raw ingredients that way.
That's true. Do we have a roaster?
You do not.
Shit.
Yeah, so it sounds like going to the fancy shop might be a... Everything's already probably all neatly packaged and sold to all those rich folk. They put it in their own...
Yeah, I mean, I'm no coffee aficionado or nothing, but I don't think they taste good when you don't roast them first.
Well, yeah, I mean, we've got fire here.
Fire roasted, that's new.
Hey, it's heat.
It's a selling point.
Roast with heat. We're gonna have to flame broil them. We're just
here only fire roasted coffee.
You know what?
Wood grilled.
Sell that shit. We could sell that shit. Fire roasted coffee in our
probably good. Yeah.
Our wood oven.
Brick oven coffee.
Out of character, that would sell right now. While we're
shit. This is our new business idea.
I'm about to start a coffee shop, and I'll laugh at all of you for doubting fire roasted coffee.
I have actually had fire roasted coffee. There is a coffee shop in Austin, Texas that roasts their coffee over. They do like wood fired coffee.
Nice.
With like oak wood, I believe, and it is actually incredible.
Where the fuck are we gonna get wood on Mars? You see trees? I don't even know what a tree looks like.
You can probably go through a terraforming bubble with trees.
I guess that's true.
Mm-hmm.
I got some of those.
Whether you know where a terraforming bubble that contains trees is, and whether those trees in the terraforming bubble are good for smoking things.
I don't know. My point is
got those,
there's just a lot of what ifs involved.
We can test with those mushrooms.
It's true. Yeah, let's open up our fucking brick oven patisserie. Can't wait.
Yeah. Oh shit, we need to start making pizza more. Anyway, we have a job to do.
Yeah, let's add yeast to the list. We need yeast and coffee.
Yeast and coffee, and that's it. All you need on your grocery list.
You've got flour?
What a combination! Delicious!
I mean, you don't have them together, right?
Yeah.
Typically, no.
There's cakes that you can... There's pastries that you can make that require both coffee and yeast.
That's true.
Or that you can like dip in your coffee. Heard that's
yeah,
a thing.
Wanted coffee flavor.
Look at me in my poncho with my coffee and my dipped pastry.
Oh, don't
la la.
Don't forget, Farley, put your pinky out.
There, cowboy.
Pinky out, baby. That's how they do it topside.
Look at fucking John Wayne over here.
Okay, so you all navigate your way over to the lifts, which crossfade. I'm assuming you still know where they are.
Yeah, I've never been on one, but
yeah.
I know
well, they have not moved since you left Reagan's.
Pretty hard to miss.
Mm.
It's a big fucking elevator with a bunch of guys with guns hanging around.
Hmm.
And we're able to take the carnival up on this lift, right? Is the lift that big where I can take vehicles up to the surface? Or
yeah, that's kind of where my concern was. Okay.
It is. Excellent.
And it is actually made for like freight vehicles because there is a lot of transportation done between the surface and the undercity.
Yes, and we're here on legitimate business.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Legitimate business.
Mm-hmm. Look, stolen goods is like a cornerstone of legitimate business, especially here in Reagan Hope.
As the as the caravan's riding up in the big elevator, Lass just kind of hanging out, sort of back in the mess hall area, just sort of manspreading, wearing his new long coat, which is concealing nothing at the moment. just sort of hanging out with his gun in his hand, just ready to go, nice. Waiting for stuff to happen.
All right. So yeah, so I guess Farley drives up to the guards and signals, talk to my boss, points to Rita. Passenger
Yo.
Side.
The guards approach the front of the truck. One stands on your side, Farley. The other one stands on Rita's side.
Window down.
Okay. Hi there. Going Greedy. Up to the surface?
I am. Just a quick resupply.
I'm sorry?
Just doing a quick resupply.
Ah, all right. All right. Okay. He writes, types some stuff into a data pad that he's holding. Looks at you. Looks at Farley.
Me.
Kind of stares at you for a second.
Yeah. Smiles wider.
I like your poncho.
Thank you. It's fancy.
It really makes a statement.
You like how it brings out my eyes?
Yeah, statement is take me out to the ball game.
I do. It's beautiful.
Oh, stop.
Yeah. It's weird, but it kind of makes me hungry. if that makes any sense. I don't know. I sound crazy. Have a nice trip.
Thank you.
He suddenly looks very uncomfortable, gets very flustered, walks away very quickly.
Farley's gonna charm our way into this place. It's beautiful poncho.
Yeah.
Farley, you see the guard on the driver's side kind of look at the guy who was on Rita's side and just go... as you guys drive onto the lift.
Nice, we didn't have to bribe him.
Hey.
That's probably a good time for a break.
All right.
That's a nice midpoint.
Yay.
In my opinion. So, yeah, stay tuned because we will be back in 10 minutes. Welcome back. Before the break, the crew woke up. Farley had a panicked awakening from his very terrifying dream in which he felt like someone was watching him. And the crew decided that they were going to make a trip to the crust of Reagan's Hope in order to steal some fancy ingredients. And also went clothes shopping. So, what are you guys doing?
I guess riding up the lift at this point.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How long is this lift ride? Like, how deep are we?
What a thrill.
You are, you are deep, beneath the crust. Probably, oh man, I don't know. I am not good at judging distance. It takes probably about a full minute for the lift to reach the surface, which is significant because the lift is moving very fast. You can feel. So eventually, you come above the surface. There is a little bit of a tunnel, and there is, very bright for Mars sunlight ahead of you. The surface city of Reagan's Hope is just enormous. It is incredible. if you, the players, have ever been in, a city the size of, say, New York, it is essentially like that, but much, much cleaner. Probably many fewer rats. I just sound like I'm knocking on New York now, and I promise that is not what I'm doing. But it is a huge, luxurious, sparkling city. The surface city of Reagan's Hope was actually built and developed by the corporate entities that began taking over Mars. So yeah.
Whoa.
There's a lot of money up here on the surface.
Oh yeah.
Wow.
Last dons a pair of wraparound shades.
So this is what it's like to be in it. Like, he does one of those like crane up neck things looking at how tall the windows are. I mean, like, how tall the buildings are, and just like, ugh. This is impressive.
Jess, I can't hear you.
I cannot hear you either. Oh no!
Whoa.
The faces, dear God! The faces!
Hello.
There you are.
Mm-hmm. Yay.
I hear you now.
We did it.
Yay. Telling you, every good Shadowcaster's stream has to have technical difficulties.
That was.
Hey, we've been doing good on not.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. We have. We have
pretty okay.
Been pretty okay for a while.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I never been up here. It's actually kind of surreal, honestly. Ugh, kind of makes me sick.
My dad told me stories about this place. None of them were good.
Yeah, he must not have been rich.
There are a number of cars on the roads up here. None of them look anything like what you've ever seen before. They are sleek, they are streamlined. A lot of them are just, they look like just a single shape. And they appear to have solar panels on the top.
Wow. Yeah. Farley's like, looks at them at like curiosities. These are silly. These aren't practical. What do you do in those things?
There's no fucking soul in that.
You get crushed in a fight.
Yeah, I don't think these folks do too much of that.
Crossway points to one of them and is like, look at that fucking thing. Nobody cared what it looked like. They just slapped it out there and said, okay, good enough.
What does it look like, CrossFit?
You said they just look like weird, smooth
mm-hmm.
shapes, right? It's like, there's no artistry in that. It's just like a fucking egg.
Well, just egg on wheels.
Like a blob on wheels, yeah.
It is. I'm gonna make an executive decision here and say that it is shaped exactly like the bean.
Like the Anish Kapoor bean?
Yes, the Anish Kapoor bean.
Or what is it, Cloud Gate?
Chicago. Yes, that is actually called Cloud Gate, but which everybody calls the bean.
Because, I mean, it's a bean.
It looks like the bean. There is also no obvious door in it. There are windows, but there is no obvious door.
Is it just like one big window? Does it look exactly like the bean?
Yes. There's like a wraparound window, in like the area that would be like the top of the bean. it looks like someone put wheels and a window on the bean.
Okay.
All right. And Farley just like tenuously merges onto the street and drives towards the artisan district.
You do see another one that is parked in a like a parallel parking area on the side of the road. And it is painted Vanta Black.
Of course it is.
This is just a Nishka Forest city.
Yeah.
We're gonna find out who leads this place and it's just his head in a jar. Mounted on a robot.
It might be.
No.
I can neither confirm nor deny that.
Alright.
Yeah, but all of the architecture is it's very streamlined, it's very simplistic, it's very geometric.
How many hexagons can we see?
So many
hexagons.
So many. Not everything is made of hexagons, but there are a number of hexagons in a lot of the architecture. There's one building that you pass that is, it looks to be just made up of windows in a hexagonal tessellated pattern.
Last is watching that one with a with sort of just this beatific smile on his face as it's going by, as if he's really appreciating the architecture. But in his mind's eye, if you can see, he's just going up to it and all the glass is shattering as he laughs and smashes it.
Of course.
If I see one more clean line, I'm gonna puke.
Hey, Let's save the trouble for after, yeah?
I mean, that's just what he's thinking in his head, right? He's just looking out the window and smiling.
That's in his thought bubble.
Okay. So,
Good Vibrations is playing.
Like, so we must, like, our food truck must look, like, pretty out of place. I mean, I know that we have a Lux vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess we sort of would look nice on the street, but it's totally dusty.
You do see a few people who are walking on the streets give you like a lingering stare. Your truck is dirtier than anything that they have seen before.
Like at a red light, I'm gonna roll down my window and look at him. You like my poncho?
They kind of look at each other and then look back at you and then they just keep walking.
What the reverse catcalling is this?
I think they liked it. Continue.
Give me compliments!
Hey, you like my t-shirt? You like what I'm wearing out there?
The fuck was that?
Yeah, Heinz 57, the people love it.
I guess not everybody here has a sense of refinement that we do.
That's true.
That's what it is.
They just can't handle the Mickey D's special that you're serving up right now.
There are a few other, freight type trucks that you pass on your way. They're not common, but there are a few others that look similar to the Carnival. They are a few years more recent than the Carnival is, but you don't look completely out of place.
That's good. I mean, I'll still stick close to those trucks whenever I get a chance, right? To just kind of continue blending in through the roads until we get to the artisan district.
All right. You arrive there after a few minutes. The architecture is somewhat different. There's more color, but as far as style goes, it kind of looks like it's mostly just the same mass-produced buildings.
Mm-hmm. All right. So where they said the coffee shop was.
Carter gave you a couple of different locations to choose from. There were a few locations that she listed as roasters, which you think you'll probably get decent results at.
Yeah, I feel like roasters would just sell roasters. You said you need roasters to make coffee, right? So we need a coffee shop.
Yeah.
Just nods knowingly.
Yeah.
Of course. Yes, exactly.
Let's check them out, though. They might be close to a coffee shop.
All right. Pull up alongside the first roaster. Say, all right, first stop, possibly our last.
I'll hop in.
All right. On the way there, you see multiple signs on a surprising number of buildings that have a figure on them that seems to be a Medusa or something of some sort. There's a number of these signs. It's strange.
Starbucks across the street from a Starbucks.
Goddess of coffee.
You've never seen this many signs with a similar symbol on them in any area as you have, areas with like a high amount of like a gang activity.
This is like exactly like. Oh, I'm imagining like when you go to Philadelphia and you go to a Dunkin' Donuts and then you walk out and there's a Dunkin' Donuts across the street from the Dunkin' Donuts.
Do I recognize this insignia?
Yeah, Rita, how much time have you spent in like major cities on the surface?
On the surface, I wouldn't say necessarily too much, but I would say I've spent a decent amount just given the fact that the commerce takes place here.
Okay,
I have done a lot of, above the table jobs.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna have you roll sharp.
Okay. Any penalties or benefits?
Yeah, take plus one.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Here we go.
Because you've spent a lot of time in commercial areas. Oh, that is a miss.
Yeah.
Yeah, you think that this is probably a gang symbol of some sort. However, the buildings that they're on appear to be shops.
Some fascist corporate symbol.
Corps are running their own gangs now.
Medusa, huh? Never much liked that story.
Stay sharp. Maybe coffee turns you to stone or something.
Oh, shit.
That's the opposite of what I want out of my coffee, but let's...
Yeah, so maybe we shouldn't stop here. Maybe we should go to the next one.
No, I'm gonna swing in there.
I mean... This place is good as any.
Yeah,
doesn't look like you can go anywhere without running into this shit, so...
Yeah, let's take it. I'm gonna head in and, see what's what.
All right. Are you going into the location that Carter marked, or are you going into the
roasters?
Okay. Yes.
All right. What do I see?
Okay. Well, are you just going in the front door?
Yeah, I just walk out of the front door just like I would be a customer.
Yeah, Lass is tagging along, buttoning up his trench coat and tying it like a bathrobe.
Okay.
Crossway's bringing up the rear.
Okay, so Cliff, you can shoot this down if you so choose, but I'm imagining, like, he doesn't button it or anything. The top half of the trench coat is just, like, halfway open, just, like, showing his chest.
Oh, no, he's got things pretty well covered up at this point.
Oh, okay.
He's wearing the shades. He's very incognito in this moment.
He looks like he's about to try to sell you watches.
Right?
All right. Rita and anybody else who's going with Rita, you enter this building, and it is a relatively large, like almost warehouse type building. The floor is made of some kind of tile. There's like a large panel of windows on the front, letting the sunlight in. The first thing that you immediately notice is that it is loud in here. There is a lot of noise from machinery. And there are about three like very large, very cylindrical machines that are toward the back of the building. The front seems to be like a storage space. There are a number of sacks that are in the front. Most of them seem to be made of like some kind of fiber. And then there are like reinforced plastic barrels that have a clear top. And inside of those barrels are what look to be coffee beans.
All right.
It's also very hot in here.
Oh, I can imagine with all the machines running.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm gonna order some coffee.
Okay. Yeah, there's a sorry, Cliff, were you gonna ask something?
Yeah, almost as soon as we walk in, and as soon as Rita draws someone's attention, Rast is gonna kind of step off into the shadows some and try to slip away and just start stealthing through this place, just getting a feel of the layout, checking out the machines, noting where the people are, just scouting out the place, but going dark. He doesn't want anyone to notice him if he can help it, and he's pretty good at sneaking around.
Okay. All right, so first I'm gonna address what Rita's doing. Rita, there is a there's like a counter in the front. There's someone sitting in like a chair, and you know, they see you coming, and they get up and they kind of like, you know, wave a little bit in greeting. They walk over to you. Hi, what can I help you with today?
Yes. I just want to get a cup of coffee.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, so this is, we were a roaster, actually, and we don't sell by the cup. I can sell you a bag of coffee, if that's what you want, but, licensing, you know, we're not set up to sell coffee by the cup.
Oh, right. So you just sell raw beans and coffee, or raw beans and roasters, basically.
No, we don't sell the roasters. The roasters belong to us.
No, I wasn't saying you sell them. Like, that's just basically what this operation is. Just.
Oh, yes.
And then you sell the beans that have been roasted.
Yes.
Okay.
You also sell raw beans if you happen to have a roaster, you know, at home, if that's, you know, one of your hobbies or anything.
Okay.
Do you roast?
I'm getting into it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, what are you roasting on?
That's what I'm here for. I'm just trying to get just, you know, the right suggestions, right ideas.
Okay, well, like I said, we don't sell roasters here. There are a number of ways that you can do it.
Okay.
Yeah, you know, I can point you to some resources on it.
Please.
Yeah, definitely. So while you two are attempting to have this conversation, that I personally could go on for hours, and I'm not going to, because
I saw your reaction. I was like, I saw it in your eyes. Like, oh boy, we're about to get a lot right here.
All right. So, last, I would like you to roll cool for me.
Who, me?
No, last.
Oh, last, right. That's a person.
Yes.
I mean, maybe. It depends on your perspective.
I'm wondering, though, could Rita... Oh, never mind. I was going to say, like, you could do an assist, maybe, to help with the... But yeah, you're good.
I'm not I don't think Last needs an SS.
Last fucking disappears. Yeah,
and I don't particularly give a shit about whether or not Rita notices me. As a matter of fact, I'm perfectly happy with Rita not realizing that I'm slipping away.
Okay.
Last isn't letting on, but he's pretty pissed at Rita right now. And Crossfade a little, too. He doesn't like how we talked about him.
Aww.
Oh,
right. All right. So, yeah. So last
time. I didn't like it either, to be fair.
Same.
So that wasn't addressed with last.
Lubricating a situation.
I'm sneaking through the place. I want to find out where things are, where the machines are, where the people are, trying to stay out of sight, but lurk around and snoop.
Okay. Man, everybody is about to lose HX with last today. Anyway. So this building is fairly, like, it's got a pretty open floor plan. It looks like it's mostly intended for, like, manufacturing and storage. But it's fancy. It's fancy manufacturing and storage. There are a number of shelves along the walls. A lot of them have smaller bags of coffee on them. There are a variety of machines in the back. And, you know, all of the people in the building are, you know, pretty easily visible. There looks to be three of them, unless there's, you know, a back room area that you don't see immediately. A lot of them, you know, three, sorry, there are four people counting the, you know, retail associate who is at the front. And the other three seem to be watching the cylindrical machines that they're using. One of them, you hear like a, you hear an alarm going off. Sounds like it's probably a timer. You know, one of the people paying attention to the machines, you know, presses a button, and lifts like a door on the front of one of the cylinders. And first of all, what you immediately notice is that smoke pours out. And then a whole lot of coffee beans pour out into a tray that is in front of the cylinder.
Okay, Last is watching this for some time, sort of lurking in the shadows.
Okay.
Just gonna take in the sights and observe what's happening. And while I observe the machines, can I tell how they're powered? Like, what are they using to make flame or heat? Can I tell where that's connected to in the building infrastructure? Just kind of following conduits and such.
Yeah, let me see. Do I want you to roll anything?
Maybe I want to read a sitch?
Okay, yeah, that's probably a good idea.
That's the name of a move?
Yes. That's it.
So that's sharp?
Yes. I don't know if this is really Rita Sitch. Or, no, it kinda is. Never mind.
So yeah, I got a 10 total for success. Nice.
You
can ask me three questions.
Okay, well, if I could pose the question, like, what is the power source for these?
Okay.
It's not on the list, but that's, can I ask that?
I mean, yeah, I will let you, because I'm not a mean GM, and a lot of these questions don't really apply. So you see a pipe going from each of these, and what looks to be a gas valve. You think that they're somehow gas powered?
Gas powered.
I saw that smile.
Okay. Last smiles more.
I'm so afraid of what
God.
Okay. Let's see. Then, just looking at where the enemies are, I guess, what's my enemy's true position? Any of these people here, like, they're not necessarily my enemies, but if they were, just hypothetically, is this all of them? And am I getting all their positions? Maybe if there's cameras or something that might belie a security room somewhere else or something.
There are a few cameras that you're able to see. They're in various positions, you know, along the walls and the ceiling. It's not like, you know, excessively heavy security or anything. But, you know, there are cameras, and there are enough of them to, like, you think probably capture, you know, most angles, if not every angle of this room.
Okay, and then my last question will be, who is in control here?
You're not 100% sure. It seems to be probably, if you had to guess, the person who you are currently watching.
Okay, that's good. I guess I will kind of bide my time a little bit and see what Rita and the rest of them are up to before deciding what to do next.
Okay.
Farley's at the
does
wheel.
Does anybody else? Hi Farley, what do you want to do?
Farley's at the wheel. Right now he's just kind of like drumming. Farley Cobra. And he's like watching out the window, like seeing how it's going.
Is he just making up a song about himself?
Yeah. The only lyric is Farley Cobra.
He's a disaster. I love him. I love him so much.
Farley Cobra. He's a hero.
Yeah.
Gonna take pollution down to zero.
And I think maybe at most he would just on top of keeping an eye out and waiting for whatever the for all the crap to go down to make the getaway drive, I think he's also like still keeping a feeler out for that feeling. I kind of want to roll open my brain.
Okay.
I don't know.
I'm just getting lost in my song but I'm just hyper aware.
Oh boy, I am so excited.
I'm afraid.
He's just concentrating on this image of this masked person.
Mm-hmm.
That's a miss.
Oh God.
Prepare for the worst.
All right. Okay. So Farley. Whew, all right. You feel like you are being physically pulled, grabbed by clawed hands and just yanked backwards out of the driver's seat. You can feel yourself hurtling through what you can only assume is the psychic maelstrom. It feels like you're in it physically, and it is extremely unsettling. You find yourself feeling almost weightless, like there is no gravity here, face to face with this masked person. And you see them grin. And then as quickly as you were pulled into the maelstrom, you were yanked back out, slammed back down into the driver's seat.
I pull out my gun and I'm just, just
you
freaking out.
If anything actually happened to you physically, but it certainly feels like it.
Yeah, like he's trying to shoot the person that was in the mask, but like his reaction time was like, because when this person was in his face, he was just kind of like paralyzed and he got shocked into like existence and he was like, no, I have to shoot you. Shit! Who are you?
Oh my god, what's wrong? What did I do? You're 16 from the doorway of the cabin.
Is it you, you little fuck?
No, I didn't do anything! What are you talking about?
So, cut away from me now. Thanks.
Okay, crossfade.
Poor 16. What do you want to do? I am just standing next to Rita, I think, just being conspicuous. But like, right, so I haven't added anything to this conversation. I'm just like nodding, like, yeah, okay, cool.
So
great ideas.
The cinematic visual that I'm getting is like this that is happening with Farley and 16 just freaking the fuck out
in mute, and then, like through the windows.
And then we just have like a close up on Crossfade's face. Just chilling.
Very calm.
And then the camera pans back out to Rita, who is talking to this person at the counter.
Yeah. Oh, you say talking, listening, really. So I'm sure they're going on yet about like all the ins and outs of various roasting types.
You say that, or are you informing me?
I'm actually listening. Like, you know, all okay of this going on, just like, okay.
Yeah. So a lot of people who are new to roasting start with a like an air popper, like for popcorn. But I really wouldn't recommend doing that because it can be a like really bad fire hazard. You really don't want to do that. And if you do it, definitely don't do it inside. You know, that's just like that's a really bad idea. It can be fine to like practice on and kind of get a feel for what you're doing, but you know, I really don't think that you should. There's you know, you can get like a little countertop one that you can put, you know, on your countertop in your kitchen. It's not very expensive. You know, it's pretty.
Hey, a quick question. Sorry to interrupt. You guys got a bathroom?
Oh yeah, there's one, you know, right over there.
Appreciate it. I walk away.
And, like, out of the corner of your eye, you probably see, like, Farley through the window, through the carnival window, like, just aiming his gun inside at someone in the back.
I'm gonna roll just for fun. So this cashier retail person, you know, while in the middle of talking to you, Rita, looks outside and their sentence kind of, they just like trail off mid-sentence, and they're staring out the window at what you soon figure out is Farley just flailing wildly in the cab of the truck.
What is that deranged cowboy doing in there?
I don't know. Should I call security? I should call security.
No, you know what? Yeah. I'll take care of it. It'll be a lot faster. By the time security gets here, who knows what he could be up to.
Okay. But I think that I should probably call security just in case.
No, it's fine.
I would like you to roll hot.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Mm-hmm. Ugh. The rolls are not nice to me today, but eh, nice enough.
Okay, that is a partial success. Yeah, so they don't really seem to have calmed down at all, but they kind of just take a step back and nod.
Yeah, just give me like 2 seconds. I'm gonna go in there. I'll take care of this.
Okay, all right.
I'm ex-military.
All right. Well, thank you very much for your service.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good luck. I don't know. I'll be watching. You know, if anything goes wrong. You know, and they hold up their you know, their comm.
All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and head back over to the truck and step inside. Like Farley, what the hell is going on?
Something is reaching out to me, Rita.
No, everything's fine. You're in the truck. Everything's fine. Just put the gun down. Set the gun down.
Something's reaching out to me, Rita. I don't think you understand. Something knows I exist.
Yes, you exist. We all know that.
Now I'm just thinking Baldi's Basics references now, because that's a weird thing my kids have been into for some reason. And none of you hopefully catch that reference.
No, nope. I don't know what that is.
Okay, good. Don't look it up.
I don't. Oh, God. Okay. Well.
All right.
Anyway.
Yes, now Farley, put the gun down so we can do this nicely. Please, I'm right here. Rita, I'm right here. We're in the truck. Everything's fine. We're literally right about to steal a bunch of coffee, but you're causing a scene and messing that up. I'm out here so we don't get security called on us preemptively.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay. No. Okay. That sounds bad.
Now.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I'm gonna pretend to punch you, and I need you to sell it so we look like I solved this.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And I'm gonna rear back, and I'm just gonna, like, lay in, like, I'm not gonna actually physically hit him, but it's gonna look good.
Yeah. Or I think, and he just, like, smacks into the cab. Just flails
wildly. Just falls right back into the chair.
All right. So, Rita, when you turn around to come back into the building, you can see the, you know, the person who you were talking to, they're kind of, like, standing in the window, and they're, like... they're watching. They're, like, fascinated, basically, by what you're doing. And... yeah, they like stare at you as you come back in.
All right, I'm gonna come in and shake my fist as I get in.
Oh, sorry.
Huh? Oh no, I'm just like gonna shake my fist like I did actual impact, and it's just been the first time in a long time.
It was nice. That was impressive. Good work out there. I was starting to get really worried.
Yeah.
So I guess I don't actually have to call security after all.
Yeah, see, sometimes the best security is right at home.
And last.
So, yeah, during this time, I guess Lask got a bit restless and started thinking of his own plan. Gathered up a few bits of, like, fabric or sack or something that were lying around. And looking around at the cameras, just how many of them are there? Like, just ballpark. We talking 2 or 3 or 16 or hundreds?
Looks like there's like 4.
4? Okay. I think 4 I can deal with. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to creep up to each one of them, try to be a little bit out of its view, get up next to it to the side, hold my hand and breathe like to fog it up a little bit. And then carefully drape some of the fabric over it so that it just kind of gradually goes fuzzy and loses the image. and I'm just gonna try to go ahead and go around and do that one by one.
Okay.
Taking my time, being real quiet. I hope.
Okay. I want you to roll for this, and I'm trying to determine what I want you to roll.
Subterfuge, maybe?
Yeah.
I
think that works.
Let me look that up here.
So
subterfuge is more like for I guess you could if you consider the cat. It's like who's a cat and mouse dynamic.
Possibly.
I'd say it's just act under fire.
Yeah, cool. But it's so cool, so same stat at least, so
okay. Yeah.
So here goes. What'd I get?
Nice.
Oh, 13. Nice. I am very cool.
Okay. So one of the employees, notices you like kind of walking around and picking up some of the coffee sacks. And they go, if you want to buy one of those, we do sell them. They are, they're going to be, a barter each. And then they go back to what they're doing.
I just sort of stop for a minute. I'm like, my hand is reaching under my trench coat where my staff is. And then it retreats and I continue on with my way.
Mm-hmm. All right. So you are able to, you're able to carry out your plan pretty much unnoticed.
Nice. Do I get all four cameras obscured?
Yes,
per camera.
I don't feel like making your roll for each one.
Okay, fair enough. I'm on the same page. Okay, once I've accomplished that, I guess, is Rita coming back in by that point, or are still things going on out there? And also, where did Crossfade go? I'm looking for Crossfade.
Where did Crossfade go?
Crossfade has kind of wandered off and is scouting out just the positions of all the people in here.
Mm-hmm.
Under the idea that they're looking for the bathroom. They're trying to kind of find a place in here where they can see everyone that there is to see, I guess, for the most part.
Okay. It's pretty easy to see where all the people are.
Okay.
While Rita is still out of the building, the retail person kind of notices you wandering around, and they're like, "Oh, the bathroom is over there. It's right there."
Thank you. I have horrible sense of direction.
You see the door right there.
Oh, is that what? Oh, okay. Yeah. Got it. Yep.
Are you okay?
I'm yeah, I'm good. I don't have the best eyesight. It's all.
There's this store that I went to get the glasses that I'm wearing, and it was great. They were not terribly expensive, and they're so fashionable. They are like very in style right now. Yeah, if you want me to, I'd like tell you how to get there after you're done in the bathroom, I can do that.
You know, that sounds great. I can't really wear glasses though on account of.
Yeah, I saw that. That's really cool. That's a really cool fashion piece.
I have a respiratory condition.
Because you need to use the bathroom. I'll leave you alone.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. Talk soon.
If you want to talk about that once you're done,
Yeah, for sure. And then I just dart into the bathroom. Like, Jesus.
And at about this time, Rita comes back in. Farley, are you doing anything else?
I think he's gonna like go with it, right? And he's just gonna like pretend that he's like, oh, my face, and make this big show, and then like just pull the truck away off into the quote unquote distance, but really just kind of pulling it around the other side.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I don't know. I don't think he feels. He still feels like haunted by the experience.
Mm-hmm.
He's just trying to like, stay focused. Like I'm in it. I'm dependable. That's me, Farley Cobra.
Farley Cobra, dependable guy.
Yeah.
That's what it says on this driver's license.
It's a fake driver's license.
Yeah. For sure,
doesn't have a license. Come on. All right,
Rita, what are you doing? All right, so I'm heading back in, and I'm just like, okay. All right. Yeah, that's where. Actually, so I'm assuming I would need something more low end. I wouldn't want something like these like industrial style roasters, would I?
No, probably not if you're just doing it, like, you know, for yourself.
Okay, just...
If you're, you know, I mean, well... You know, if you run a restaurant or anything, you might want to get, like, a slightly bigger one. There are some that take, like, 5 pounds, as opposed to, like, the little 1 pound countertop ones. You know, but those are a lot more expensive. Yeah, you're looking into like the you know, like the 7 barter range there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's bit out of my reach, unfortunately. Okay. Yeah, Say about the beans, like what are the beans here like? I've had real coffee maybe a handful of times, and I just like want to know what to really kind of expect out of your beans here.
Oh wow, well I am so excited to teach you more about, you know, the coffee that we have here. So this kind, and she you know, she points to one of the barrels that you know, has the clear top that you can see the coffee beans through.
Okay.
This kind, you know, they're all grown in like various areas around Mars, but those areas are actually engineered specifically to replicate the climates of various regions on Earth that the coffee originally came from. And based on all of those different growing regions, you know, they have completely different flavor profiles, and, you know, they all look different. They're completely different, you know, just they're all very special. And she launches into this big long explanation about, you know, each type of bean, how it's prepared, what the flavor profile is like, how best to you know, prepare it for like consumption, stuff like that.
All right. Because I'm just more or less trying to buy time.
Mm-hmm.
Because I noticed when I got back, my compatriots were not just hanging around by me. Mm-hmm. So I'm just like, okay, let me keep this person distracted for a bit longer. So I'm just gonna, you know, keep asking more and more questions about like the roasting process, just the beans, their origins, what kind of flavors does what, yada yada yada. Just making questions up from the information that's given to me, because again, I've had coffee literally a handful of times in my life as Rita, so it's just like, yeah. And this and this and that and that. Okay.
Oppo research.
Yeah.
I think CrossFit like edges out of the bathroom once they hear Rita and the person talking again. They're like, oh god, finally. Jesus Christ. And they kind of get back to their recon mission. So there is, yeah, there's for sure a place in here where everybody in here, I can see them and they can see me, right?
Yes.
Okay. Well, before I do anything, I'm going to try to find Last.
Last is also very easy to find. Yeah, like I said, this building is pretty, it's got a pretty open floor plan. There's not a lot of like walls or anything. Well, I mean, there are four walls that make up the building structure, but there aren't like rooms or anything. You know, Last is very like obviously visible.
Okay.
I wanted to know, these three people that are back here, are they spread out doing different things, or are they all like together working on the same project or task?
They're all doing various jobs. You're able to kind of figure out, you think that they are preparing roasted coffee.
Okay, how close are they together?
There's probably a good 6 feet between each of them. They're social distancing.
Okay. Well, Last is going to, I guess, good, jump down, like just jump in between like two of them. Mm-hmm. He's got a staff in his hand. He's still wearing his trench coat and sunglasses. But he flicks a switch, and out of one end of the staff pops this big, slender spike. And out of the other side pops this, swings out this nasty-looking curved blade. And he does a swish and a swick and murders both of them.
Jesus Christ!
Oh my god! The third person screams.
I'm going to go for them as soon as I can possibly do it. I'm trying to murder these people as quickly and quietly as possible.
So okay.
Switch, turn around, off with the head. I don't know if I have to roll for this, but...
I will not make you roll for the first one. I am going to make you roll for the second one. You are... Oh, God. If I could only remember what the fucking moves are.
Sucker someone, for sure. When you attack someone unsuspecting or helpless, ask the MC if you could miss.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You could miss.
Then treat it as go aggro on someone, but your victim has no choice to cave and do what you want.
Which is die?
Well. Well, you're going to have to roll.
I guess so, yeah.
All right, well, I like that move because it's based on cool in my case.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, completely succeed. So, Last, how do you kill this poor innocent coffee roaster?
My weapon is area, so I can basically attack everyone within reach with the one attack. So the spike goes through the back of one of them and sticks out the front of them. They look down at it before they die, and then I pull that out when there's a wicking motion, and the other person just falls. They turned to see what the noise was, and their throat just gets cut open, and blood just sprays out as they fall over, grasping it, just with this look of shock and confusion on their face.
All right.
And then, yeah, just without missing a beat, Last is stepping towards the third one, twirling the staff blade thing. Just this look of cold determination on his face.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent.
Great. Okay, so I'm going to have the retail person go next. They take out their comm out of their pocket, and they... run for the door.
I guess I want to go take chase to them.
Mm-hmm.
And fuck. It was inevitable. It was inevitable.
Well,
I wanted to separate her from that calm. I don't want to. I'm not going to try to murder her because she's been really nice. Mm-hmm. Even though she's probably just another. Boozy pig.
Trying to talk. Hey, relax. We're doing an action scene. It's totally just a prank show.
I got the cameras.
I don't think I'm gonna do that, but I'm just gonna go run and just like
well,
try
great,
to tackle her.
That would not have succeeded at all.
Dang.
Okay, so you're gonna run after her.
Yeah, I'm gonna take chase.
Okay.
Chase.
Is there a specific?
Yeah. So Chase is under the subterfuge moves. So you are the
okay.
cat.
Roll okay. Cool. Okay. All right.
Alright, so I'm rolling.
You're rolling cool.
Alright, fair. Wow, you played some cool. Here goes nothing.
Uh-oh.
Ah, partial.
That's a partial success. Okay, so you're trying to catch up to her and get the comm out of her hand, right?
Yeah, I'm just trying to knock that away from her. Like,
okay.
I don't have my convenient shotgun, but I guess I do have a knife. But I don't want to use. I don't want to use that.
Okay. Well, you can't attack her right now.
Okay.
So on a 7 to 9, you've had to follow them where they wanted to go. They say where. You're able to catch up with her. I'm gonna say she runs into the building across the street, with one of the Medusa signs above the door, and you are able to get into the building after her, but only after you hear her scream, "Somebody call security!"
Fuck! I'm gonna run back.
Okay.
No.
All right.
And I'm like jamming four into the beepers, so okay. The rest of the crew is alerted that shit's going down.
Oh my god. All right.
Crossfire like emerges from the bathroom to basically see Lash just murder all these people all of a sudden.
Yeah. Like a fucking blood.
Well, fuck.
I haven't killed the third one yet, I don't think. But
well, I guess this is what we're doing now. You know, I had a plan. I was gonna try to get us out of here without this, but all right. Fucking hell.
I knew that you had a plan, and I knew that Crossfade was going to try to enact it, but honestly, it is 100% in character for Latch to just fucking ruin it.
I was coming out of the bathroom to try to find Latch to tell him about my plan.
I said that in the most charitable way possible.
Yeah, and Last that probably would have been fine if you hadn't said those things before and pissed Last off, so yeah. He's kind of going for an
error. We're gonna have that conversation later.
So yeah, so anyway. If I can, like yeah, Last is gonna behead the last person here. Step forward and pick their head off with the blade.
In the Starbucks?
I mean, like, I'm not mad at Last for doing that, but
it's gonna be fucking Carter.
It's definitely I wasn't expecting him to go fucking straight up Yojimbo.
Farley, would you like to do anything?
I see Rita run this way after, or like I see someone run from the street, from the roasters, to the Medusa shop. See Rita follow and then run back with a totally different face of shit, and I'm like, just thumbs up. We're on, right? We're on. I think this is the signal. All right.
Yeah.
like, turns imagine the Scooby-Doo door chasing, like.
Yes. Turns the carnival on and is ready. Just like, he'll hop out, stroll to the back, open the back. Ready to take cargo.
All right.
I think maybe 16, 17. I think they might need you in there. Go.
Okay. I don't know what to do.
Just grab everything that you can and put it in here.
Okay, everything. All right, I guess.
So upon seeing Last murder the last person, Crosshead is just like, well, just runs over to like a big bag of coffee beans and starts like struggling to try to lift it with their little noodle arm.
How tight are the lids on those barrels?
They are okay. I would like to tell you something before you decide to do that. Crossfade, these barrels are on wheels.
Oh, okay. Well, I was like, I don't know, I guess I was picturing like burlap sacks full of beans.
Yeah, there are burlap sacks full of beans, or they're not burlap. They're made of some kind of fiber that you can't.
Yeah, we're
really
in 2400s, like
future burlap.
Future burlap, exactly.
Space burlap, spurlap.
Yeah. Spurlap. God. All right. Yeah. So yeah, you can do that.
Okay. Wait, what can I do? Hold on. What am I doing?
I'm sorry. I don't know.
Roll some beans in the truck. Let's go.
Oh my god. All right. Yeah, you can begin moving the beans that are in barrels.
Okay. So I'm like trying to push it with my like cyberware arm and like motioning Last out with the other arm. Like, all right, let's fucking go. Let's get the shit and get out.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Last is just sort of looking around, kind of casually taking his time. Lights a smoke. Moves over to one of the barrels and starts pushing it toward the front.
Hmm.
Starts to pick up some speed. Helps load. Kind of when 16 and 17 come in, look around what to do. He points over to some of the coffee.
Just beyond the bodies and the blood on the floor.
Yeah, don't worry about that.
And yeah, he's going to start helping load up a bunch of coffee until it's time to go.
All right. Okay, so Crossfade, you're able to move the barrels. They are heavy.
Yeah, it helps to get both arms on them.
Yeah.
At least.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but they're movable. They roll. Last, I think you have a much easier time with them. Yeah. And then Rita.
All right. I'm going to be getting roasters disconnected and dismantled because, yeah, I think they've got coffee beans under control.
Mm-hmm.
But we do need a roaster.
Okay. The, all of the roasters are hot. They are very, very hot. Two of them have coffee currently being roasted in them.
Okay. Well, shit.
The timer alarm goes off on one of them.
Yeah, it's great, but it's still hot, though. Fuck. Hey,
free sample.
Yeah, well, I mean, you got a lot of free samples right now.
That's true.
I really don't want to make another stop. Fuck. Well, I'm gonna start shutting off the gas on them. And hopefully, give that some time for some to cool down.
Okay.
The one that Dunner went off and last comes back in, he's going to walk over to it and push the lid open like you saw those other people do, and then tip it over to knock to spill the coffee beans out.
Okay, it doesn't, you don't have to tip it over if you open the little door on the front, it just comes out.
Okay, he's going to do what he saw them do.
Yeah, okay, so as part of Rita's turn, I am starting a clock.
Ooh. Oh, shit.
And I don't know how to move this text because it wants to snap to the grid, and I don't know how to make it stop doing that because I don't know how to fucking use Roll20.
Oh,
okay.
There's a way, I'll tell you.
I got it.
Okay, yes, please help me.
Like, there's a little tab, and you can just click the cogwheel on the map, and it'll...
Oh, thank you.
Or, you know, the other GM can do that.
That is also fine. I have used Roll20 so much, and I use it so often, and, like, I've been using it for 3 years? 4 years? I don't know. I have no idea how it works.
Well, I mean, if...
I've never been able to figure that out.
It varies based on your context. I mean, if you're running games all the time with it, that's one thing, but... Yeah.
All right, well, we have the fancy clock screen up so they can see that we have one of four high slices filled. Shit.
Yes.
That is a tiny clock.
So, security was called on your last turn, Rita, and there will be three more turns before it arrives.
All right. When I see 17, I tell him to get on the gun.
This is one of the areas that security actually gives a shit about.
Yep.
It last turns to Rita and says, after opening up the coffee thing, and says, "Hey, where's the fourth one?"
The fourth what?
The clerk you were talking to?
There were four. I couldn't keep up with her. She made it to the other place, and she called for help. So we need to move quickly.
What? Where?
Across the street. And she's the lost cause.
Glasgow's running off that way.
No.
What?
All right. Crossfade, what are you up to?
Oh my god, I'm just rolling beans. Just bean rolling. We're trying to get out of here. All right. I'm getting fucking killed.
Okay. is there a ramp up toward the back of the truck? I feel like there should be. I feel like there should be because you guys
like a loading ramp. Yeah, we
used it before.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Farley's like prepared everything when he saw Rita run in. It's like, okay, this is go time. And so sees Crossfade struggling and like, should I be on the road? I should be in the cab, like ready to go. Sorry.
It's fine.
Was that sorry in character?
Sorry in character. Yeah.
Okay. I was going to say, I really hope that was in character.
I'm also sorry. Oz is also sorry.
Not struggling so much now that they're actually using both arms to push and not just trying to push with their one.
Valid.
Yeah. I'm gonna say this super quickly before I forget. I would like both Farley and Crossfade to mark an experience right now. Crossfade, as an apology for your plan that you didn't get to use, and
so sad.
Farley, for your sorry that I don't know was supposed to be in character, but should have been. Should definitely be.
It is in character, yeah. It's both me and Farley.
It's very good.
Yeah, not helping. Right. I have to be ready to go at a moment's notice.
It's true.
Rena, would you like to do anything else?
Also union rules.
Yeah, you know.
I don't move coffee.
I'm just
it's not covered.
I'm just trying to find the coolest fucking roaster. I just need one. And I'll be good. So I'm just like quickly running through trying to touch them to just try to find one I can just, okay, this is good enough, and then run off with it.
Okay. All right. Okay. So you do end up finding one of the little like 5-pound roasters that the clerk was telling you about. Okay. And it's How strong is Rita?
A little bit.
Okay.
I'll gladly roll on it.
Okay.
I'd roll hard.
Roll. I guess.
Yeah.
That's probably the most analogous thing to like strength.
Yeah. All right. Let's do it. Fuck.
Yeah. You cannot lift this piece of equipment on your own.
Damn it, last.
Are you calling out for him, or you're just saying that to yourself?
I was gonna be like, last, help.
He turns around and damn it, and comes back running back.
Oh, whoa. Thank God.
Okay.
You gotta be ready for security if somebody called. They're fast around here. You were supposed to take care of, like, I took care of three, okay?
I don't think
that called an alarm.
I don't think that your characters know that security is extremely fast here. Oh. But you get the feeling that this is
it's a big city place, of course it is.
Yeah. I didn't know that you were gonna kick the plan off when you did. I'm sorry. I didn't know we just were not in sync. It's fine. Shit happens.
You bought beans and things for so long, dragging it out.
Because I knew y'all were up to things, so I was giving you time to prepare. I was just trying to buy time.
I don't take that long. Never mind. What do you need?
I need help lifting this. So we can get the hell out of here.
We're taking one of these with?
Yeah, we gotta roast the beans.
All right.
Okay, Crossfade, what are you doing?
I think while they're having this conversation, Crossfade, you just see, like, running back and forth in the back, pushing barrels of beans. They're just like, hurry the fuck up!
Okay.
They roll by, they're, like, on top of the barrel.
Okay, Crossfade, I would like you to roll me a d6 okay. And divide it by two.
Well, now I gotta get my d6s.
Okay.
Hold on. Well, I rolled a 6, so that'll be a 3.
Okay, you're able to get 3 barrels outside.
Yay! Nice.
It's because I've got a system now where I use my momentum to get the barrel rolling, and then I just, skate on it.
Crossfade may not be very strong, but they are certainly fast. You were able to get the barrels outside. It's going to take a lot more force and a lot more time to actually get them into the truck. But you were able to get 3 of them outside in one turn.
Yay.
Farley, what are you doing?
Farley Cobra. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba, Farley Cobra. And he's like, I think he's just keeping an eye out. He's trying to see if he can hear security when it's approaching and
just be a sharp.
Yep.
Read a sitch, actually.
Okay. All right, so that is...
Which is sharp as well, so. All
right. Yeah, but you were specifically reading a sitch.
Yep. That's a miss.
Oh, boy. Okay, ask one.
Read a sitch. Why can't I find it now?
Hang on, I am showing it to players now.
Found it.
Oh, okay, well.
All right.
So, on a miss, ask one anyway, but be prepared for the worst.
Oh, good. What is... Ooh, okay, there's 2 that I want to ask, but I can only ask one and
you can only ask one.
All right, fine. What's my best escape route? And be prepared for the worst.
Yeah. You have one escape route.
Mm-hmm.
The street is too narrow for the carnival to turn around on. You can go forward.
Mm-hmm.
And you hear sirens.
So, into the security is my best escape.
Maybe. With a 3 on your roll, you cannot tell which direction they're coming from.
Yeah, so forward. Got it. Mm-hmm. I think Farley is going to give the signal honks on the carnival. Like, get on.
Mm-hmm. And as part of your be prepared for the worst.
Oh, that wasn't enough?
As a mechanical addition to your be prepared for the worst, I'm filling in another section of the clock.
Oh no.
You have one round.
Oh no.
All right.
I got my 3 barrels out. I'm pushing them up into the truck and getting the fuck on and getting ready to blow out of here.
Okay. Rita and last.
All right.
I'm assuming that you guys are acting together.
Yeah, I'm like getting the machine like ready to be moved, like disconnecting all the cabling or the hosing and stuff like that. And I'm letting last do the lifting.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, Last is doing his best to help pick up and move this thing.
Okay, are you lifting it together?
Actually, what I want to do is, there's those barrels that have the wheels on it. Are there any of them left around here, or are they all gone?
Roll me 2d6. If you have a stat that has a 0 in it, that is easy to do.
I don't know the syntaxes for roll 20. Can somebody just roll 20?
I think it's,
slash R space.
Yeah. Slash roll, and then 2d6.
7.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. So that is a partial success. There's a barrel. It doesn't have any coffee in it.
I'm not concerned about the coffee, just more of the thing with the wheels. So that's great. I'll sort of pull it over, kind of bring it over so we can angle this thing down and have something with wheels on it that we can each sort of sit on one side and move it along with to kind of truck it over, because it's probably too heavy for us, for me to just like Arnold Schwarzenegger it out of here. Mm.
It is a pretty big, heavy piece of machinery. So that's probably the case.
So yeah, makeshift dolly, whatever. And I'll holler for 16 to get the fuck over here and help.
Okay. Crossfade, I would like you.
Yes.
To roll another d6 for me, please.
Okay. Five.
Okay. So you got 3 barrels out, right?
Yes.
Okay. You're able to get 2 of them up.
Okay. The ramp.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
Whatever. Good enough. I hear the sirens coming and I'm like,
get in!
What are you doing, Farley?
Honk, 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 honk. Get in!
I'm assuming you're in the driver's seat now.
Yes. Oh, Farley's been in the driver's seat the whole time. That's why he didn't help out Crossfade, because he's ready to roll.
Back in the building, Tarita, what's got him so excited?
Probably security. If I had to guess. Or he could be doing whatever the fuck he was doing earlier.
Relax, it's too late to miss the first wave. We'll kill them and get out of here before the second gets here.
Or we just leave.
What are you doing?
Just shrugs and helps move stuff.
Yep, I'm gonna just help get that barrel or get that machine out.
All right. Roll cool for me.
Both of us or?
You can assist. You can also do an assist. Like, you can have one person do it later and assist.
Oh, yes, you can do an assist. Okay.
All right.
I was. Yeah.
Who's assisting who?
For rolling cool, that's my best thing, so.
All right, I'll assist you then.
Okay.
That way, if I fail, you can probably still carry it yourself. I just roll cool myself, though, right?
No, you roll your history with me.
Oh! Oh, damn. That sucks. Hey!
Also, thank you for knowing how assist works, because I couldn't remember. All right, that is a partial success.
Is that what? Plus
that's a plus one.
I think that's it. Yeah, let's make
it. Plus one, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That gives me a 12, so okay. Yeah, it's in my dice rolls tonight.
All right, yes, yeah, so you succeed completely. Nice. You were able to get the barrel and the small roasting machine into the car. The truck? Whatever it is. Yeah, you're able to get it in. And you are all in the truck. Farley, why did I roll that? That's not what I wanted to do. I have roll 20. What are you doing? So Farley, you are about to get the truck moving when you see multiple of these little bean-shaped vehicles come careening around a corner, and they stop in front of you, and they have, you know, flashing red and blue lights on them.
That's cute. I ram into them.
All of our trouble begins and ends with beans today, clearly.
Yep. Yep.
Alright.
I ram through them.
Okay. Ramming speed.
Well, roll for me, please.
Okay. So let's see.
You are boy. I think we're shouldering vehicles here.
I am I'm definitely ramming vehicles. Yep. It's shouldering other vehicles. All right, so I roll cool. Oh god. Also, hold on. I have my daredevil move. If I go straight into danger without hedging bets, I have plus 1 armor.
Ooh.
Okay. So, just in case. Ah. Partial success.
Okay, partial success. Okay, on a hit, you shoulder it aside, inflicting V harm as established.
Okay, so the vehicle harm is, since I'm just like direct, against another vehicle, it's a direct hit because I'm basically just ramming through these. So it's 3 harm plus our massive rating, which is 3. So 6 vehicle harm. Minus their massive plus armor.
Okay.
And that's 6, but then I also have I have some other bonuses. Let me see. I have plus 3 damage. I always deal plus 3 damage. So I'm at 9 vehicle damage.
Mm. Okay. So you're dealing 9 damage?
Yes.
Jesus.
Oh my god. Well. Okay. So.
Pretty sure that fills up a clock.
Yeah. Hang on. Remind me how this works.
So it's just like
the carnival has 12.
No, well, I use the 12 clock, but like it's you fill in the first 3 for the first section, the second 3 for, so like you do like a 3 o'clock, a 6 o'clock, a 9 o'clock, and then you do 10, 11, 12. So those are your 6 sections overall.
Yeah. Okay.
I always found the way they laid that out to be confusing.
Yep. Yeah. That fills up a clock. So it is super confusing. I don't like it. It doesn't make sense.
They do it because it's supposed to like emulate the apocalypse style like doomsday clocks. But yeah, it is confusing.
Ah, okay.
But it's for theme and flavor. But yes. 6 sections. I do 6. I do 9 damage minus whatever their massive and armor is.
Okay. Yeah. They're not gonna survive that. So yeah, you just fucking floor it. And you know, you ram these vehicles. They just like crunch under the carnival's wheels. And the carnival speeds forward.
Back in the cargo hold, last turns to Rita as we're just trying to lock down the cargo as we're moving. You think we hit something?
Now, because it's a ram or a T-bone of another vehicle, we also suffered the harm. So I have to roll harm for the vehicle. I'm just gonna roll my own harm because I don't think the vehicles have like they don't have a die that I can roll. So.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, they haven't really taken any harm. So just plus zero and see what happens. Okay, partial success.
Okay.
I'm looking for the information. Let me see.
Attacker, which in this case would be the GM, chooses one. You give ground, you're driven off course or forced onto a new course, or your vehicle takes one harm that pierces armor.
Okay, I'm sorry. What am I, which move am I looking at right now?
Suffer V harm.
V harm.
Under okay. Reaction.
That's what I thought.
Yeah.
My attack. 7 to 9 results, so.
Yeah, so you choose one Mac of those.
Okay. I'm gonna say you're driven off course. There's not much of another place to go. You are heading toward the buildings on either side of the street now.
Yeah. Oh. So like I see like all of these here. Like I was gonna go one way to like get back to the course that I know, but I see all these security vehicles, so I'm just like, all right, we're improvising, and I just go down a totally new route that I don't know.
Okay. Yeah,
cool.
So you go around a corner, because that's really the only place that you can go at this point. And around this corner, there is a blockade of like armored vehicles. And in front of one of the vehicles, he's in one, you see the person who you've seen in your vision.
They're standing in front of the vehicles.
No, I'm sorry. I said that at first and then I was like, wait, no, okay. That's stupid. He's not in front of the vehicle. He is in one of them.
He's in one of them.
You can see him. And I would like you to roll weird.
Okay. So when I rolled weird the last time and went through my episode, I leveled up. And I took the weather eye move when I opened my brain to the world psychic maelstrom. Am I doing that?
You are not.
Damn it. All right, fine. Regular weird.
But what does this move do?
I roll cool instead of weird.
Ah, okay. Well, you're not opening your brain.
Fine.
You are rolling weird.
All right. All right.
It was like, God, things keep getting so fucking weird in this game.
Okay, partial success. My first partial success rolling weirds.
Okay, partial success. All right. So, hang on, let me look at something real quick.
No.
One moment. One moment. I am sorry. I definitely should have looked this up beforehand.
Let
You just hear in a very calm, very smooth voice, stop the truck.
So, question. My surrounding, when you said, when you said that the artisan district is up somewhere, are we talking like Z-axis up, or are we talking like deep in the city up? Like, is everything on level, or is there, are we on a upper section of the city that I could possibly not be on?
No. You have no way of driving off. You are on the top. You are on the top layer. It is one solid layer. I mean, you're on the surface of Mars. You can go down the tunnels to
get there. Yeah.
Go underground, but you are, as far as you know, not near any of the tunnels.
Am I like, are we like cornered, or do we have anything that I could drive into or through or off or up?
There's a building behind them.
Behind, so we are cornered, is what you are saying.
Yes.
How armored do these vehicles look?
They are very armored. They're right. Like military grade vehicles.
I think carefully, which is not at all, and I say, go fuck yourself, and I ram through that vehicle specifically.
Okay. I would like you to roll weird again.
Oh god. What is happening? And this is still not Psychic Maelstrom? Partial success.
It is not Psychic Maelstrom.
Mac.
Mac, stop it.
Yeah, I'm like flooring the vehicle right now, just like beelining it towards them. Wow, whatever this is happening. You're reading things.
She's smiling too much.
She's smiling, reading things.
Don't like it.
Sorry, have you rolled yet, or am
I did. Partial success.
Oh, okay. All right. You didn't say anything. I wasn't sure if that was the previous roll.
Yeah, no.
All right. So here's what I'm gonna have happen. You ram the vehicles in front of you. They slide back, you know, with probably a few feet. And the carnival skids to a halt.
I think in this sudden stop, like, I don't know, like, CrossFit was not secured to anything, and they just, like, fly into the cab. fuck!
Master just grabbed one of the oh shit handles and was sort of flung around it.
So, I'm going to enforce my will as GM over you. Farley. You feel suddenly unable to continue moving the truck. You're not sure why. This person, you see them, they're in the passenger seat of like one of these armored vehicles, and they get out, and they stand in front of you, and you can hear them speaking, but it also feels like their words are being projected directly into your mind. Hello, Farley. It's so nice to finally meet you. And this is where we're gonna end.
Nah.
That felt right.
All right, we'll leave it there for next week.
What?
So catch us next Tuesday, August 11th from 8 to 11 p.m. Eastern to find out what happens next. Please
what
like, share, and
next?
And don't forget to follow our notifications.
Oz is going to fucking die in the interim.
Oh my god. Damn it.
Just to remember Oz.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I know. I agreed.
Yes. Yes. We did discuss this beforehand.
We did. This is acceptable.
Yes.
I was just hoping I could. I wanted to see how far I could get.
Yeah. I also, like, I know that a lot of things involving, like, this sort of thing, basically, like, mind control adjacent stuff, mm-hmm. can be, like, a pretty hard line for a lot of players. I wanted to clear it with the people it would be affecting beforehand.
Deserve this.
So, yeah, just to make sure that we're cool and I'm not making anybody uncomfortable.
That's fine. I deserve this.
I'm a good GM who cares about my players.
Bam.
Yeah.
Well, we are...
I want you guys to have fun, but I also want your characters to suffer.
Good.
I'm sorry.
Good.
Jesus.
So, we're not done just yet. So, if for those of you who are watching us live, stick around after the show because we're going to be doing a Q&A.
I'm and curious, but there's a fire truck outside of my apartment.
Yep.
Oh, boy. Well, I hope everything's okay.
Me too.
Yeah.
I don't smell anything burning.
Well, before we call it a night, we need to trigger the session end move. Let's go around the table, allow everybody a moment to plug themselves, and tell us which character knows your character better than they used to. Zeph, we're going to start with you.
All right. I am actually up to some stuff this time around. I think...
Wow!
Right? Next
amazing.
Week...
Amazing! I'm so proud of you.
I think week... Not this Friday, but next Friday, I believe I'll be starting on a Legend of the Five Rings game with the people over at Riddle.
Oh, yay!
Yeah, that's me. And as far as characters that know me a little bit better this time around, I'm going to go ahead and say last. That took a point away last time, but... We got the chance to work together today and fight a little bit. But I feel like Last knows you a bit better given that interaction.
Okay, so Last, mark one HX with Rita, plus one HX. Oz, you're up.
Hi everybody, I'm Oz. I am one of the lead developers here on the Shadowcasters Network for our wonderful content such as this. And you can follow me at Ozcore. Ding, that's my Twitter. And I'm also the voice of Ziggy on Radio Free Detroit. So go and check that out because that is a wonderful podcast where I play a troll and a Shadowrunning philosopher. Not in like a good troll, like a big troll. Not a...
Like a big cool troll.
Big cool troll, not internet troll. So character that knows Farley better today is... I gotta say it's Crossfade still. Mm. Yeah. I think it's Crossfade. Crossfade has really seen... Obviously, Farley's going through some shit, and I think Crossfade has seen the more of the intricacies of his, like, all of the loose screws.
Right.
In his clockwork that none of it works, and things are, like, pointing and falling off, and... Yeah.
That's one way to put it.
Yeah.
All right. So Crossfade, mark plus one HX with Farley.
Will do. And then, yeah, me. I'm next. So I'm Jess. Me! I play Jedi on Pink Mohawk Edition, which is Shadowrun Anarchy actual play. If you want to check that out, you can hit up our official Twitter at Pink Mohawk Pod. Otherwise, my personal Twitter is One Shot Mini Boss. It's all one word. And sometimes I'm on Twitch at twitch.tv/ectopossum. And the character that knows Crossfade together, yeah, that's good. the character that knows Crossfade better today. I'm gonna say it's mutual. It's Farley.
Yeah.
Because we've had some moments trying to figure out what the fuck was going on with Farley.
Mm-hmm. And you got me this neat poncho. Now you know my fashion.
Yeah, I got you.
Fashion. I know your fashion. Mm. Yeah, I don't know.
We know. No, we get each other.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Farley, mark an HX with Crossfade. And Cliff, you're next.
Hi, I'm Clifton, a founding member of the Shadowcasters Network, also known as Mr. Johnson of the Ecology Podcast, also the GM on Legends of Earthdawn and Earthdawn Actual Play Podcast, and I'm the musician Prism Shard. Some of the music we played tonight was by Kevin McLeod of Incompetech, and some of it was by me. So if you like the background music that's playing right now, check out soundcloud.com/prismshard with the hyphen in between. Let's see. I think I'm going to go the route today where, like, last kind of, like, split off and lone wolfed it. He was a little bit upset by how his friends were talking about him, and, like, just he didn't like that people were, like, stepping into cover for him and make excuses, and he really didn't like the things they said, even though he knows they didn't really mean them that way, but it just kind of put him in something of an emotional funk. And he also doesn't like this place and was looking forward to an excuse to, you know, do some mayhem. Being a battle babe, he's super dangerous and just likely to do unexpected, horrible, dangerous things from time to time. So that's why I kind of thought, like, setting things up to just kill the people who worked here and steal their coffee made perfect sense to him. So I'm going to say, like, nobody really understands Last better. And I think given that Last screwed up Crossfade's plan when Crossfade turned to involve him in their plan, I think Crossfade's going to get the -1 with Last.
Ah.
As much as I'd like to see them become better friends, I think that makes sense for this. And out of character, I apologize for screwing up your plan.
I'm trying. That's okay.
I was pretty, like, far on the, like, I'm doing this in my mindset by that point and did not pick up on your cues of character either.
The visual of Crossfade coming out of the bathroom to go talk to Last about the plan just to see him fucking murdering all these people was pretty good, though, so.
It was pretty
I'm thinking, like, the, you know that gif from...
Is it the community one where he's got the pizza boxes and everything's on fire? Yes.
But it's, like, worse.
Yeah, somehow. It is so much worse.
It's worse, yeah.
Yeah.
Crossfade's got the pizza. It's like, the fuck just happened here?
Well, I kind of feel like I'm that scene in, what, Spider-Man, was it? Where, I can't remember his name. The Marvel guy, Stan Lee. Where Stan Lee's, like, in the library or whatever with his headphones on and they're bawling in the background. Like, that's kind of how I feel right now. I'm just like, oh yeah, so B is like, shink, shink, shink. Like, wait, what?
Okay. Yeah, so Crossfade, mark that -1 HX with Last.
I did.
Yay, good job. And I'm Max Shepard. I am the audio engineer for Pink Mohawk Edition, which is the Shatter and Anarchy Actual Play podcast that Jess mentioned earlier. I am working on a new episode right now. So if you are a fan of the show, you are in luck because there will be a new episode soon. I'm also a game developer and writer with Fragging Unicorns Games, which has a Kickstarter that is still incredibly successful and is still going on right now. Go back, Gangs of the Undercity. We've got some incredible minis as, like, stretch goals. I don't know if I can talk about this on stream. I think it's okay. I don't think Opti will mind. We had a new mini revealed to us, the developers, that is a cyber griffin. And however cool you think that sounds, it is actually, like, 10 times cooler. That's awesome. You will definitely want to get it. So yeah, go check that out. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you again for our next live episode, which is next Tuesday, August 11th. For those of you watching us live, stick around for a quick Q&A and we'll be reading your super chats. Take care out there. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.